Okay. So, if anybody misses the beginning, they're not going to have an easy time catching up to the end. So I'm going to get started. That's fine. If the water is flowing down the mountain, my process of seduction and magic is this. I'm going to open a pathway where the water will have the least resistance to flow the direction I want it to go. How you do that is a mystery to people, but I'm going to show you some actual techniques. That's what it's a workshop. Like, you'll be able to apply them right away. Not only that, I'll show you how it works out. We do it. The first thing we have to decide is where we want the water to flow. So before, we're going to talk about women, we're going to talk about business. I mean, those are the areas that I'm very interested in, communication. Before you begin your seduction, it starts inside, and you have to ask yourself, what do I want her, what state of mind do I want her to be in? So that's the question, right? What state of mind? And many men will say, I want her to be sexual, okay? And I agree with you. I would like a woman to be sexual around me. If she's not, that's weird. I have a hard time around a woman who's not sexual, right? That's fucking awkward. I don't know how to interact with an unsexual woman. You know, isn't that weird? Like, it's kind of awkward. For me, it is. But how do we, sexual would be here. Look, the bottom. To get there, we're gonna have to move her there. And the first step that's missed by a lot of people is I want her to be totally relaxed. I want her to be comfortable, and I want her to be relaxed. Okay? Now get that again, because this is vital in you being able to take people's minds and move them, which is what I do. You want the person you're talking to be comfortable and relaxed. Now, there's other schools of thought. That's fine. They can do what they want to do. I'm telling you what I do. So the water starts here, and it's flowing down the path of least resistance, right? It never goes uphill, or if it does, maybe somewhere on the planet or something, right? But mostly it goes downhill, and it goes around the rocks. And so when I say I want her to be relaxed, another way of saying it is I am now going to create another pathway that if she moves in the direction that I go, she's going to feel more comfortable, and she's going to feel more relaxed. When? In that moment. That's what you're looking for. So wherever you are, that's your seduction. It starts right there. I want her to be more relaxed and more comfortable starting now. Okay? Starting here. She's going to be sexual, absolutely, without a doubt. But now, I want her to be relaxed. So now check this out. If you yourself have unnecessary tension in your body, you will trigger it in others. Is that fair to say? Right? Yeah. Like a stranger, you're downstairs, a guy walks up, he's like, hey man, and you're like, whoa, he's tense. What the fuck does he want? Right? Another guy looks exactly like him, he's more relaxed. He's like, hey man, and you're like, what does he want? Right? Same guy, two different approaches. So you yourself have to start working with your relaxation. Okay? Key. Then I focus on her relaxing. That's the first step. We saw each other yesterday for the first time, right? Good. Do you recall at any moment me saying or hinting towards relaxing and comfort? You do, right? Okay. She's not gonna be like, you fucker, that's what you were doing yesterday. Okay? But you remember that? Okay. Because that's my first step. Okay? That's my first step. Gotta be relaxed. Gotta be comfortable. Why? So I can talk to you. So we remove some of the barriers to me having a conversation. And if you're tense, every time I reach, she's like, She might even put up with it, right? But it gets tense. I want her to be relaxed. As relaxed as possible. So what are some ways that we could do that? First, you relax yourself, right? Second, we can start to talk about things that are relaxing. Like what? Like I could be like,
traveling.
No, I'm thinking of it. I'm doing it. Just like this. It's happening right now. You're waiting for the words. You need to pay attention to the energy. The sigh that I took was the beginning of me relaxing her. Watch this. She comes to your house. She comes to your hotel. You sit down, you put the shit down. You sit down and you do this, look. See, subtly, what I'm doing? Subtly, I'm relaxing. By taking a moment, breathing, relaxing my shoulders, then not saying anything yet, but then relaxing again. Now, I know this fact, that if a person's around me, they're gonna start feeling my emotions. I can't help it, right? So that's where the relaxation starts, by me demonstrating that I'm telling her, I'm leading, it's time to relax, okay? I may, depending, next do something like this. After I do that, I say, so, how's it going, or whatever, and then as she's talking, I go like this. Oh, God. That's a new one. Oh, shit, huh? I'm actually talking to her. Watch what I said. Oh, shit, huh? She will, So, I'm subtly communicating. There's one communication that's like blah, blah, blah. But subtly I'm saying, baby, relax. It's time to just chill the fuck out for just a second. I will, as I'm sitting down, lean back a little bit, maybe nod. I'm just relaxing down, step by step. Do you get where we're going with it? After relaxation, and simultaneously with relaxation, right, comes comfort. Now, I know this. If she's uncomfortable with her body, her clothes will stay on, okay? If she's uncomfortable with anything in that area, she's protecting shit. I need her to become comfortable in her own skin, in her environment. So what you'll see is, whatever environment you're in, you scan the environment and you'll do something like this. It's too bright or too dark in here. Music, TV. I'm now changing the environment to make it comfortable. I'm removing uncomfortable pieces. But I'm in charge of the environment. She's under my protection, you could say. This is my mindset. I need her to relax, and I need her to be comfortable. And I lead the way myself. I go from there. Everybody get that? Good. Now here is where the power is. Now this is the technique. I'm going to show you a technique reserved for the highest level sorcerers in the world. You say it as it is, so I'm gonna show you. Ready? It goes like this. Obviously, this right here, this group, you are the people who've taken the next step. Not everybody's here, right? We've been eating for a while, and you're listening to me talk. And up until now, you've had 2 days of listening to some incredible speeches. Now, what I want you to do for just a second, and notice, if there's any change in you at all that's happened in the last day or so, even a slight change. Okay, pause, that's it. Let me show you what I did. Once you get to the relaxation, once you get to the comfort, that's a process, then you do something very simple. You state things as they are. And the reason why you're doing that is so that her mind starts trusting exactly what you're saying. You're gonna argue with, you couldn't argue with anything I said. Obviously you're here, you play the extra step. Ate the food, blah, 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 blah. Oh, yeah, yeah, what's happening? Okay, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, okay. Then what happened? We went, now people know this, it's not like the secret of all secrets, they just don't know how to fucking apply it, okay? There's an application, there's knowledge, not the same thing. What's happening in this case is after we state, the technique is after you state 3-4 things that are happening, this is the second step, you ask her to check something internally that is available. So, it would look something like this. Finally we see each other. Hang out after 3 years of you stalking me on IG, and me stalking you. Yeah, some true shit. We were stalkers of each other. And we're gonna go to this event. And now I wonder if you notice, if you're more calm and comfortable than when you first walked in here. Stop. Do you remember something similar like that yesterday that I said to you? Is there any memory of that? Me saying, are you more relaxed? Do you feel anything? How do you remember that shit? That's what I was doing. Do you like me any less? Are you hating me now? Okay, good. Okay. So, stating it as it is, then from there, asking an internal question so that the mind goes outside. Yeah, he's right. Yeah, we're right here. Let me check. Boom. The moment the mind shifts and goes inwards, I walk right in. Hi. With her. I say, can you check? Are you more comfortable? She goes, here we go, yeah. I just stepped a little closer into the area that I want in the mind. Here you are looking at a house. You guys want to move. This is a beautiful neighborhood. You chose this place and you wanted 3 bedrooms. It's 3 bedrooms. And now I'm wondering, if you take a look, do you feel more comfortable in here now than when you first walked in here? Real estate. I watch them. I listen. They go right there. You see that? That little move? Looking in the mind? I walk right in. They go, I don't care what they say. I don't care. I'm just moving from the outside to the inside. So what I need is I need access to the internal world. That's where my magic is. It happens inside her. Oh, many different ways to live same, yeah? This is the formula. This is happening, this is happening, this is happening. Yeah, you're right. And I wonder, take a look. I think so, I don't think so, blah, blah, blah. It doesn't matter. Then you do this. And the frame you put behind it doesn't matter. So, if I said, let's try something. No, I'm just kidding. Don't do it, right? You know what I mean? But I'm just pretending. Let's try something. My teacher, he told me that breathing is one of the most important things in life. After all, if you don't breathe, you're dead, right? So he gave me this exercise where you, watch this, you take a deep breath in, hold. Relax your shoulders. Take a deep breath in. Relax your shoulders. You don't even have to do it. As I'm doing it, your breathing will change as you're watching me. Do you get that? Subtly it'll change. So once I moved into her mind by saying, did you check that? She said, oh, yeah, I'm a little more comfortable. I go, here's this thing that I was taught about breathing. I want to now access her breathing. In real estate, yeah, I do feel a little more comfortable in here. You know what? One of the coolest things is when you take a moment and you just breathe in that new air. See, it just happens. If you keep doing it, people will start doing it. And I watch them. I want their body and their mind to respond to my commands. But it's all happening subtly. You see the difference? This is a subtle art. The more subtle, the better. So subtle. So subtle that the first time your penis touches her, she fucking orgasms everywhere. That's real shit. But people are like, how do you make her come so fast? No, bro, I've been making her come for an hour by talking to her. Subtly, I've been telling her body all the things it needs to know on how to orgasm. So when the time comes, I can say, come. The fuck happened to you? How did you do that? It was an hour-long process. You just got that, come. You just got this. Okay, then sign the papers. Okay, man, you sell everything. No, I started selling the moment they walked up. I was talking to them then. Here's the process. Water starts here. It flows. You create a new pathway for it by relaxing and creating comfort. That's if it's more relaxed and comfortable to follow your commands, she will go there. Because the body naturally doesn't want to be tense. You remember what Nick said about stress? I completely agree with that. I hate that word. It's disgusting. Right? It's weird. What the fuck does that mean? So, if you create more comfort and relaxation, she will naturally, her body and mind will go, even watch this. This I've seen many times. Sometimes she will consciously try to resist it. She'll be like this, no, I have a boyfriend, I have a husband, I'm gay, I have a penis, I have a tail. I don't care what the fuck she says, right? She's like, she's talking to herself, no, I can't. And you're like, yeah, that's fine, baby. Of course, you shouldn't. But what you're really communicating subtly is, baby, you're doing it. If she goes with her own decision, she tenses up. It's like, if they decide to buy the house, they can relax into their life. Finally, no fighting between the man and the woman, since she's destroying his life every fucking moment. You can finally go home, bro, and have your man cave in the fucking basement. You'll be okay. She'll leave you alone, right? But if they don't choose the choice you give them, more tension is created. So you're creating this weird bind in their mind, which is, follow my lead and you feel better. You have a choice. Don't follow my lead and deal with the consequences. It's up to you.
Fine, I don't give a fuck, right? You're not the only person I'm seducing. It's not the only house I'm selling. I wouldn't be able to live. I'm talking to everybody. This is what I do. It's my art. I love doing it. It's great taking a woman who's tense and making her more comfortable, more relaxed, more comfortable, more relaxed, then asking how she feels, then taking her from there where we're going right now, right? Walking into her mind and getting a glimpse of what's happening. We create the least resistance. Water starts trickling this way. More relaxed, more comfort. We go back to relaxation and comfort. It cycles. And then the water starts to flow. We're going to take her to sex, right? I need her to be totally comfortable and totally relaxed before sex is even an issue. Although sex is always an issue. For example, I want them to buy the house before buying is even an issue. I need them to relax before buying is an issue. Although buying the house is the issue already. I don't know if that makes sense to you. Okay? But anyways. You say things as they are. Here we are, you're listening to me. Now I've been talking about 12, 13 minutes. Some of the stuff I say makes sense to you. Some of it maybe you don't agree with, some you do. Regardless, you can check now and see if there's any change in the way you're watching me. If your body's more relaxed, if you're more calm. I walk in right with you now. And if you've done that, it might be a good time to take a moment and breathe. Because you're breathing all the time. But when you control your breathing, you can feel even better. Ah, we're on it. You've now taken 2-3 steps inside her mind. What are you doing? You're able to relax her body. You're able to start to regulate her breathing. You get what's happening here. Are you with me on this? I know there's distraction in the back. Why is there distraction? Okay? Water is now flowing down the proper channels. So here's how I want you to think about seduction, sales, confidence. Anything you want. Think of it as it's a process that takes place. And you need to start to trigger this process, starting with the mind and moving into the body. When you trigger the process, for example, let's talk about, because we want to get to sex, right? In her mind, she starts to feel, or she starts to think. She starts to think, God, I feel more comfortable right now. No, I'm more relaxed right now. She's thinking that, right? She started thinking in the beginning, what does he want to do? I don't know. I have a fucking husband. Blah, whatever the fuck she's thinking, right? After talking a little bit, she starts thinking, oh, it's not so bad. I like that. I like the water. Hey, that's good. Water's flowing a different path, right? And then from there, she starts, oh, my breathing's a little deeper. Do you have something to drink here? Are you thirsty? Yes. Now, even if I suggest water, and I just grab the water, and I do this, here you go, and she grabs it, let's say, and she drinks it, that's not missed by me. Once again, I'm subtly suggesting you're thirsty. So the whole process becomes, I will take complete control of your mind and body. And I'm not sorry about it. And if you like to take control, go ahead and watch how tense you get. Because remember, you walked into my life tense, fucked up, anxiety ridden, and a piece of shit. Right? That's why I was telling you, if you put them on the pedestal, you fucked up. I pick women up from the sewer. Right? Walking in the sewer, like, oh, it's that shiny object. I pick it up, oh my God, it's a fucking diamond. Right? People have been shitting on it. I take it away, I start washing it. More shit comes out. I'm like, what the fuck? She's the one shitting on herself. Okay? But eventually I clean that shit up and she sees what I see. She goes, you know what? I am a diamond. I say, yeah, you are, baby. That's why I'm talking to you. But if I let you go, you fall back in the shit. You know how I know that? How old are you? You ain't fucking 5 years old. You're 22, 25, 30, 38, 40, 50. The oldest I've been with, somewhere in the 60s. I didn't ask her. I didn't want to ask. If you live fucking over 50 fucking years and you still have anxiety and you still got fucking worries and shit like that, you missed something. Okay? You fucked up real bad. But that's my job as a man. I'm okay with it. Clean you up. Now, as long as you ride with me, it's my job to keep you shining. Watch this. It's not her job to start shining. That is not female energy. Female is the moon. Male is the sun, yin and yang, alchemy. The sun is male. Arash didn't make this up, this is old school. Male shines energy. The penis goes forward, shoots semen. The vagina is female energy, dark. Kills billions of your babies. Mother, women are so nurturing. No, they're not. You shot a billion sperm in her. And they were fighting. And she was like, die, bah, 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 bah. Ha ha, try again, dude. Finally, one gets in, but by fighting his way. That's why if you made it, at least on a genetic level, you're a fighter, right? You beat out a lot of fucking competition, and she tried to kill you, and she killed all your brothers and sisters. She's a murderer. Yeah, whatever. I'm being funny, but not really. Okay. What I am saying is this: is that the man shines, the woman absorbs. Now think, you fuck, you shoot, she absorbs. You finish sex, you're like, oh, don't want to talk. She's like, where are you going? Why are you so fucking energetic, bitch? What the fuck happened here? You fed her literally life. She took your life. She's all excited. Okay? Female energy is dark, receptive. The moon symbolizes female in alchemy. The sun symbolizes male. The moon, right now, is lighting up because it took the light of the sun. Otherwise, it's a rock. All of my women, every single one of my women without me are nothing. They should know that. I have no problem telling them that because they were nothing when they met me. Oh, well, I'm somebody. Okay, fuck you. Even if I meet Beyonce, who's a superstar, I will show her what she can do because she's lacking in a lot of fucking areas. I just have to watch her move and see the tension in her fucking speech. You can see it. You can't hide. So here's a rule, a rule of magic. Pretend as if everybody knows every thought you have and you can't hide anything. We're talking about this, man. See, I don't think I can hide anything from you, so I don't try to. Or from her. I call the big elephant in the room, something comes up, I'm like, blah, blah. Have you experienced that in the last day or so? Where I'm just like, hey, this is in the way before we interact. Right? That's what it is. Well, what if she doesn't like you? Then she wouldn't like me for who I am. That's cool. Right? Big deal. Whatever. And sometimes, you know, it hurts your feelings, but not really, you do it long enough. So female is dark, yin in Chinese. Yang, energy, male. You, when you go around and you look for that support system in a woman, you will break at some point. She's not to be my backbone. Get it? Nope. I don't want to rely on her for emotional strength. It's none of her business. I don't want to rely on her for intellectual. I have a lot of great intellectual friends. They're in this room. A 5-10 minute conversation with them would just blow anyone's mind. I don't need a woman to talk to me like that. You get what I'm saying? Why the fuck would I waste my time with a woman? Like, they'd be like, well, don't you want her to be smart? Yes, I want her to be fucking smart. But she's very smart if she comes in my life and says, Arash, I want to be yours. Then you're a fucking genius. You just beat out all the other bitches before you. God damn, I'm going to invest in you. That's how I evaluate their intelligence, based on how they see me. So I don't have this thing where you chase the one who doesn't like you. The one who doesn't like me, I want to have nothing to do with. She is a fucking moron. Are you kidding me, bitch? After even 2 minutes of conversation, you can't tell? You think I'm like the fucking Joes in the world? You're so fucking stupid, I hit you with a bat, you still won't get it. Fuck off. See, that's the proper attitude, okay? Well, if you had $1 billion, would you be like, please take it, I don't want to take it, please take it. All right, well, fuck you, you take it. Somebody will take it, right? That's your value. All right, let's go back to the magic, so I'm gonna teach you this process. It goes, relax, comfort, opens a pathway. You start moving, then you start stating things as they are so that her mind can't argue. I don't wanna argue, you don't wanna argue with your clients, right? That's the stupidest thing you could do with your client, right? Argue with them. Why? What is your problem? Right? They're there and they want to buy a product from you. You're like, let's argue about this shit. No, fuck that. There's no argument. And same thing. I don't want to argue with a woman. I've heard this bullshit before. I want a woman that will put me in my place. Well, you need to grow the fuck up as a man. That's what you need. You need a woman to put you in your place? What, you looking for a mom? I can understand if you're 7 and you say that, and your mom should have some boundaries around you. But as a grown man, a woman puts me in my place, I'm sorry, you go back and watch your little sitcoms that tell you that's how it should be. But that's not real life for me. As it starts to flow down, we're going to take her to sexuality. We start to control, subtly, her breathing, her thirst, her images in her mind. How do we control images in her mind? There's a million different ways we could do it. We could do something like this. We could do, if you could eat anything right now, we're going to have food. What would be the most exotic food you could have? Look, I'm looking just for a subtle cue that goes like this. She's looking at me, she goes like this. I don't care about the answer. She could say shrimp, she could say ass, I don't care. She goes, it's gotta be that when I talk, her mind moves. When I talk, her mind moves. I move her mind. Because if I move her mind, I can move her legs. You see that? But I'm not trying to move her legs. She's, no, you know, my boyfriend, my husband, my fucking, come on, baby. No, let me show you a better way to live using your communication as art. It's an art form. Don't do drive-by talking. Something here. Be specific. Be clear. Be relaxed. Now, sometimes people ask me, they're like, how are you in sex? I'm me. I'm exactly like this. Things slow down a little bit, right? Because I'm lecturing. I wouldn't be talking to her. And then we're gonna do this. And then we're gonna eat. Get ready for your panties to fly off of you. What the fuck? This is not gonna happen. So there's a rhythm. Okay? So as you come down and you're gonna go to sex, here's what I'll teach you. Sex is a rhythm. 7 laws of alchemy. One of them is rhythm. Sex is a rhythm. Anger is a rhythm. Sadness is a rhythm. You should be able to walk in a room and know it was a funeral. Every one of you can walk in and be like, something's wrong, someone ducks home. Right? You feel it. You should be able to walk in and know someone's celebrating. Right? Good. Now, if I don't feel that sex in the air, if I don't create it, there's no need to push it. Just like if I don't see the sale, I'm a businessman, you know? I'm not gonna push the sale. You need to buy. You know what I don't do? You need to buy now. You go, I don't fucking do that shit. If you haven't bought it yet, I haven't done my job yet. Okay? And my job is real simple. I either have a product that works or it doesn't. If it does, then communication is what's missing. Or you're a fucking moron. But there's not too many of those people. There's more good people than bad people in the world, right? So your job, if you don't entice her mind and her emotions to open her body up to have sex with you, it's not time to push for sex yet. That's my way. Okay? Now, if you do it right, every part of her will tell you she wants to fuck you. I can say that with the door, yeah. Every part of her would say to you she wants to fuck you, and she could consciously even say to you, I don't know, I don't think we're, just so you know, we're not having sex. Her words are that, and you're watching her, you're like, baby, we've already had sex in your mind 5 times. You've been fucking me the whole time. And when you know that, you could relax, right? The guy's drooling over that Mercedes or something, and you know he has the money, you know that. And he said it, and he called this girl, and he's just like, you know what, I gotta be more responsible. I need to go to school and be a loser or some shit, okay, good. And he's just like, bro, you bought this car 10 times already. You, at that moment, back the fuck up. No problem. You're right, you should be responsible. So I'm going to teach you a phrase, you know, this magic is communication magic. So I wanted to show you techniques in this, right? Here's one. I agree with that. And I'd like to add to that, just that structure. I agree with that. I'd like to add to that. So it looks like this. I need to be responsible. I agree with that. Absolutely. In fact, you know, responsibility is one of the main things to be successful. And I'd like to add to that, that this is the car that every single woman is gonna drool over when they see you in it. What you don't do is you don't separate them into 2 choices. You make them into 1 choice. You agree with them. Hey, I'm married, I have a boyfriend, I'm gay, I whatever. Absolutely. There's nothing more beautiful than a woman who knows that, who knows she's married, knows she has a boyfriend. That loyalty is incredible. And I want to add to that, that you know all of that. and you're still here making an independent decision. Absolutely, and that's what I respect. There's no pushing here. There's only having a good time. Do you get what I'm saying? You don't oppose in the mind, because if you oppose in the mind, she splits you up and you become the enemy. I'm not. You're always like right next to her. She's built up this castle, shooting all the guys on there. They're bearing gifts. Princess, princess, I mean, if you just give me your vagina, I will give you. Oh yeah, put the gift there. Pop, pop, pop. Okay? Princess, no, you I don't even want that anymore, right? Meanwhile, as she's doing that, there's this old man walking by. She's like, who are you? No, I'm just cleaning the place. Open the door for the old man. Thank you. And he's like, shut the door, people are coming. Okay, I'll be in this room. Changes. Smooth as pop. Stands next to her. Shoot him! Shoot him! She's like, who are you? Don't worry, shoot. Do the arrow. Take this one. Pull that one out. Wow, thank you for helping me out. Yeah, no problem. Okay? How'd you get in here? I don't know, I was here the whole time. In that room. That's the way to look at it. Anytime you resist it, it becomes solid. You get it? That's the mind. That's in the mind. If you want to make something solid for someone, make them resist it. For example, this is why therapy doesn't work. Right? This is why therapy doesn't work. They tell you that shit, right? If they're like, let go, let go, let go. Let go of what? Because the act of saying let go holds on to it. That's why I like the stress thing you said. Stress what? What does that mean? I don't even have a definition for that. Guess when you'll hear me say stress? Never. Because that's how you let go. But if I was like, let go of stress, let go of stress. You don't want to have any stress. Stress is no good. Many people suffer from stress, but you can be okay with stress. I just keep creating stress, 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 stress. Do you know what abracadabra means? No. You don't know what abracadabra?
What I say becomes.
What I say becomes reality, or I create it with my words. You didn't know that. It's on my head. You should know that. What I say becomes real. So you never, ever, ever in your relationship, ever say shit like this. I don't feel like you appreciate me anymore. You say it like this. One of the times that I'm most attracted to you is when I can feel your appreciation. Those are the times where I'm more into you than you fucking know. Same communication. One, I put in her mind, you don't appreciate me. The other one I let in her mind, you appreciate me and I like that shit. That's abracadabra. You're walking around creating your reality constantly with what you say. Oh man, I don't know, I'm just nervous. Oh, I shouldn't be nervous, okay. Let me just pump up so I'm not nervous. There's nervous, nervous, nervous. You're nervous, nervous, nervous. In fact, your mind doesn't know a negative. You know what that means? If I said to you, do not, no matter what you do, do not buy a BMW. Here's what you do in your mind. You go, BMW, no. You see that? Anything, right? Let's pretend you're not gay. Do not, no matter what, suck a dick. You gotta be like, suck a dick? No. Right? Get my water. So you have to understand the trick of the mind is that it doesn't recognize a nothing. It has to go to something, then it has to erase it. You get what I'm saying? So if you want to be powerful, or more powerful is the proper term, what you do is you go, what should my reality consist of? And you pick certain words that your life should be about. Power, beauty, money, magic, freedom, women, whatever. And you go, this is how I describe my world, even when it's not the way it should be. Right? So what you don't say is, nobody likes me and I just don't know how to get girls. You go, wait, my world is beauty, magic. You go, I'm gonna get more freedom and more power so I can have all the women that I want in my life. That's fine. And it's like, well, you're into positive thinking? No, I'm into thinking. Positive, negative, I'm into creating my reality with my thoughts and my words. Do I still have you as an audience or am I losing? Good. Now you see, that's an example. Me saying, am I losing, is not the most incredible way of putting it out there. So now let me show you how it's done properly. Do I still have you as an audience? Oh, hold on, there's more to it. Thank you. Do I still have you as an audience, or should I continue to amaze you? See that? See, if I had stated it like that, your energy would have come up. Do I still have you as an audience, or should I continue to amaze you more? Yes. Continue to amaze this more, see that? And so what? Your mind prepares for that, okay. You see that? But look at what I did earlier, as an example. Do I still have you audience, or am I losing? No, we got you. Dave, thank you. Thank you for your fucking pity. No, bro, keep going. We're with you.
Where's my phone?
Oh, clean charge. Hold on. We still got you.
Sorry. That's fine.
Okay, another 10 minutes or so. We start here. She's not worried about sex. She wants to use you for some drinks or some shit. She wants to come over because she's heartbroken over her boyfriend. She thinks it's great to get some compliments from you or whatever. Comes down, she's relaxed and comfortable. You start controlling her breathing. There's more to it, her rhythm of the heart. Just basically, you go from outside to inside, step by step. Once you get to the inside, you do this. You gotta check your work. Yes. That's what people miss. You gotta check it, make sure it's there. How do you check your work?
Well,
a lot of subtle ways you can do it. I like subtlety. So you now think you have her breathing, you think you have her thirst and all that shit going on, then you just do a few things. As you're talking, you start shifting your body position certain ways, changing your face, she'll start following you. It's the same thing in sales. When they want to buy, they'll follow you. You just have to have a little patience. It's not like I go like this and she goes like that immediately. It's like I go like this, and we talk, and she starts to get uncomfortable where she was, and she'll shift. Give it a little time. You gotta have a little patience, okay? Now, you know what's very unseductive? It's very unseductive. It's pushing something faster than it should go. Did you know that? You gotta let it marinate a little bit. So I stopped calling myself a pickup artist, and I started calling myself a seduction artist for that reason, by the way. Pickup was very fast, and I enjoy it. But seduction is you marinating that shit, right? Now I told you, we've known of each other for about 2.5, how long? 2 years, you know?
About
2.5 years! You would think 2 years ago, after half a year, I would have like, enough stalking on IG. Stop liking that picture. No, why? It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Why would I stop my life? Because there's some weird timeline on it. Until I die, if I want something, I go for it. If I don't want it, I'll stop because I don't want it. Not because there's a time, somebody's arbitrary timeline. You know what I'm saying? It's like, you want that mansion? Well, if you don't get it by next year, might as well give up. What the fuck? Right? The fuck are you talking about? You keep going. All right, technique. So what's the actual technique is, I agree with that, I like to add to that, blah, 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 blah. Real simple, right? No problem. Now I'll teach you one more because it comes from the alchemy principles of polarity, and I'll show you how it works. If you really want to do well, what you do is you figure out what the two poles of the situation are. So I'll give you an example. Let's say you know that possibility is, let's do sales for first, the person has been lied to, cheated, manipulated, and they bought shit they don't want to buy. They regretted their purchase, right? Everybody who's an adult has done that. You also know that they bought things that they really were happy they spent the money on. It happened. So before you sell, you do this. You say, listen, here's what I know. In your life, you've purchased many things that people try to sell to you, and you spent the money, and it was garbage. I've been in the same situation. Nothing worse than spending money on something, then going home and hating it, regretting it. Hate that shit. At the same time, there's been a time in your life, I'm sure, as it has in mine, where you've bought something and you're like, man, I can't believe that's all I paid for that. It's incredible. And you get the agreement. Can you see how that would be an agreement? I'm hitting both poles. I acknowledge both. Then I go into it, and I say, now, this product, I firmly believe in it 100%. Okay? And since I've had that experience you're talking about, I wouldn't be able to sleep with myself, sleep at night, if I sold a bogus product. Are you with me?
Yeah.
Good. Just saying that will ease the tension. In seduction, it's the same thing. I'm sure men have tried to have sex with you. I'm sure friends of yours, guys, stuck around to fuck you behind your boyfriend's back and all that shit. I get it. And I'm sure you made that mistake before and it's destroyed your relationship. And there may have been a time in your life where you took a chance with somebody and ended up being like the greatest relationship you ever had. I've been in both situations. Okay? Now, here's what I care about. Never, ever, ever destroying your relationship. That's not who I am. Ever. In fact, if you and I are going to hang out or do anything, it would have to make you and myself greater. Just as long as we're clear on that, then we can move forward in whatever we do. Boom. How's that as a woman, by the way? Are you even listening or sitting? Okay. So this is hitting both polarities. Are you with me? Good. So, example, if I was going to do it right now, I would say this. You've been listening all day. Your body gets tired. You start getting kind of like, just ate, digesting, relaxing. And I've been there. Right, where you want to focus and it's like words are coming in. And there's been other times where just the right sentence hits you and you get it. And I'm not asking you to listen to everything that I'm saying to you. But I'm telling you that there will be something that I've said so far that will completely alter the way you interact with the world. You see how that eases the tension on you as the listener and it allows you to listen better to me? Do you get that? That's magic. That's what this is. Removing the rocks. And I say it's more comfortable to listen to me than not. You see that? I could do the opposite and say, you have to listen to me. You have to listen to me. You see what happens? Resistance comes here. Oh, no, not really. I'll pretend. I'll pretend because I'm trapped. See how that works, right? That's how she feels. Vince, how much longer?
We're doing good. I'm trying to locate Thomas. I apologize. Oh, yeah, please. Thank
how much longer do I have?
Let me see. 8:25. Keep it rolling. It's good.
Give me a time so I can calibrate my phone.
15 minutes. 15.
I'll be done in 15, okay?
Yeah.
Wrapping it up. Cool. Because I'm going to take questions. Okay. Everybody see that? So when you catch yourself doing this and that, just go, okay, what is being resisted? Let me call it and let me have reality on it. Have I experienced that shit? Yes. Here's what could happen, right? You could make a mistake hooking up with somebody because blah, blah, blah. I've been there and I totally get it. But let me, the other side, you could be making the greatest decision. Hey, you remember Akito and I picked up two girls last night at the very end of the night, right? We're walking, let me take you through the pickup. You'll see them tonight because he's been texting me all fucking day trying to show up. But here's how it happened. We're trying to find our car, his car, and two girls across the street. And I just go, hey, is there your car or some shit? She was like, rah, 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 rah. So we walk a little faster across the street. There's a guy with them. And I'm like, yeah, we can't get into the car either. But we start to catch up to them. So now I'm shoulder to shoulder. I take a few more steps forward, start talking backwards. He catches up, two girls. As we're walking, I'm like, how's your night? Ah, no good. I said, yeah. Sometimes nights are shitty. Remember that? Nights are shitty. I said, but you know what's interesting? Sometimes, right when you think it's the shittiest time of your life that you had, something could happen, and it could shift the whole thing where it becomes the most incredible night because there's a lot of possibilities. Like, you know what? You're right. Yeah, I like when they do that. Like, they're so fucking wise, and they improve on me. You know what? You're right. I'm like, yeah. And blah, 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 and keep going. And then we walk past these three Russian mafia guys, it looked like. And somebody, one of the girls is like, did you guys lose your car? They're like, no. Thick accent. We lost our apartment. You lost your apartment, right? So I was like, yeah, dude, that sucks when that happens. And we keep going. And she's like, I said, dude, you don't fuck with three fucking Russian guys who say they lost their apartment. In the middle of the night. I don't know what the fuck that even means. That sentence is psychotic, right? I'm like, be quiet. So we keep going, and then we start using that as a joke. Losing our apartment. I'm like, fuck, dude. They lost their apartment. That's I don't know what drugs they're on and shit. So keep going downstairs, and at some point, we're now walking. I said, listen. Have you ever heard of players? You know, guys in music videos, rap videos, player. Yeah. So, him and I are two of the top players on the planet. I fuck more women than you could ever fucking imagine. So, I was like, and I'm just telling you right now, if you want to come over and hang out, okay, we're probably not going to fuck. I'm so honest. I said, yeah, it is. Hell honest. And I said, now pay attention. Do you remember when I first met you across the street? Do you remember how you felt? How do you feel now? Oh, I feel way better. I said, because from the first one I said hi to you till now, I've been strategically getting you to the point where you want to hang out with me. I'm like, hey, on my life, my mom, yeah, everybody, right? Oh, wow, that's so cool. Yeah. Exchange phone numbers. Text me all day. Should be at the party tonight. Can't wait to see you guys. But the polarity, you've had a shitty night, it happens, I've had shitty nights. But sometimes your shitty nights can be incredible. You didn't realize that? And then I move them there. You say, I know the water's flowing this way, but you know, sometimes the water flows this way. And sometimes when it goes, it's even a better place. Like, yeah, I've seen that. Okay, last one's pretty slow. Okay? Then you check in the middle. You check your words. How do you feel right now? Oh, I feel like shit, I was angry, now I'm so pissed. You fucked up. That's not the time to be like, hey, you wanna come over? Right? That's the time to be like, I gotta re-strategize. So, let's go over some of these basic laws. If you wanna have sex with you, get her relaxed and comfortable. Simple. One of the questions people always ask, you know, it's one of the old datums in the community, which is, what do you want a woman to feel? I want her to feel fascinated, I want her to feel intrigued. That's great. I want her to feel relaxed and comfortable, period. Okay? I want her to feel like she's got a fucking soul massage. A brain massage. Oh my God. Why have I been carrying so much stress? Because you're fucked up. That's why. Okay? That's why. Better now? Yeah. God, I feel so good when I'm with you. Good. You do, don't you? That's right. Good. Relax and comfortable. Move into that. That's a much bigger, obviously, practice than what I gave you, but I just gave you that. You move from the outside environment to the internal world. You move right with her internal. Then you start guiding her neurology and everything, and you're there once you got that. When you understand that, anytime someone resists you, you know, I'm sorry, I don't give my number to guys, I don't give my number to girls, whatever the fuck that happens, you say, you know what, I totally agree with that. And I'd like to add to that, that if it was somebody who was just trying to get your phone number to hook up with you, I would say the same thing. But did you know that tomorrow night would be the biggest party in Hollywood, and everyone's going to be there, and you look like the kind of person who would actually enjoy it. And that is the reason why I'm talking to you. So I accept it. Gives me a little bit more time. Yeah, but I know, but she feels kind of bad. But we don't want to party. That's okay. Then there's more techniques for that, but we could just use that. I agree with what you're saying, and I like to add to it this, which means I accept the energy you gave me, and I turn it around, and I push it back at you a lot more. Welcome to Martial Arts of the Mind, okay? And then finally, the two polarities, which is one of the laws of alchemy. How do you use it? Very simple. The moment you start moving into the area, you start feeling the negative pole pulling. Don't start pushing the positive pole. You start creating a dynamic tension. She will insist on the negative. Hey, you know, you should just feel better. I feel like shit. But you know what? Life is so wonderful. Fuck that. You know, I'm getting into this whole thing. That is not how you fix someone. You say this. You're fucked up? Man, you are fucked up. Right? Here's what I've always thought. Person goes to the therapist, says, doctor, I want to kill myself. The doctor should go like this. Open the drawer. Grab a gun. Cock it. And point. And I would like to see the person go, thank you. But you know what's gonna happen? Hey, hey, hey! What the fuck are you doing? Helping you out. But I thought you were supposed to help me. I'm fucking helping you. No. Hey, put that shit down. You mean you don't wanna die? Are you sure? See, I can cure you both ways. I can shoot you. Or you can say, put the gun down. If I put the gun down, you wanna live, right? Yeah, right. That's what I thought. You push them in their shit, you know? I have so much anxiety. Man, you're a fucking wreck. Oh, what? No, not that bad. Yeah, you are. You're horrible. I get anxiety being around you. No, I mean, I just had such a rough day. Your day was hell. How are you even walking? You should be in a wheelchair right now, so fucked up. It's not that bad. Damn, bitch, fuck. What's the other way around? I have so much anxiety. No, baby, you know what? You're a lot more than that. I know, but I just can't seem to shake. She'll argue her point. You're in court suddenly. No, I have anxiety. I really do. No, I really do. Here's proof. See this shit? Here's my proof. Everybody knows it. Do you want to see the pills? You want to see this? You want to see? Have you talked to my friend? He knows. I almost killed myself. Okay? That's great. So you just go, yeah, you're right. You're fucked up. Oh my God, I look so chubby. You know, chubby is too small of a word. You put on some weight. Getting healthy, right? No, I'm not that. I mean, am I that bad? I'm pretty bad. Right? And you might be like, well, why would she talk to you? Because you're an asshole. She'll walk away and she will remember you and she will appreciate you. Okay? But you see, if a bum says that, he'll get slapped. But if Johnny Depp says that, he won't get slapped. She'll be like, he's so honest. Right? He's so honest. Did you see him? He just told me. If Johnny Depp whips out his dick and pees right here, because like, he's so free, right? He's so free, doesn't give a shit. You know how I know that? Because Jim Morrison did that. Got on top of the bar and peed. And you know what didn't happen? No girls were like, ew, they're like, Jim! He went outside, the cops taking him, he's like, oh, fuck everybody! Okay? You all fucking slaves! That's how Jim Morrison was, right? And they're like, Jim, fuck me! You're so free, I want to be able to pee on the bar! Right? What does that mean? That's our seductive instinct method, which is make sure you have value before you start saying shit. Right? You work on your value. Right? And what does that mean? You're somebody. Be somebody as a man. Right? Don't talk to somebody. I talked to somebody in the event, maybe they're here too. I said, so what are you good at? They're like, well, you know, I've been going to school for like 9 years. I was like, fuck, you fucked up, man. If I ask you as a man, what are you good at? You go, I went to school for 9 years. I go, you gotta stop right now. Because if next year you say 10 years, you are missing. If you spend 9 fucking years of your life drawing stick figures, you will be the goddamn artist by the end of it. But after 9 years, if I said, what do? You go, I go to school. Well, you're fucked up real fucking bad. Take 9 years of your life and tie your shoes and you'll be a fucking Guinness World Book of Record shoe tire. But at the end of school, you're just like, I've just been not going to school. Good for you. Okay? All right, I'm gonna wrap this up. Magic, alchemy, sorcery, whatever you call it. There are many levels, many forms of it. There are very few people in modern times that can do it, or if they can, they don't talk about it. I haven't talked about it in a very long time. I haven't, till recent times. And there's a reason why I'm talking about it now. There's more of it, and more will be revealed as time goes forward, okay? But you need to understand something. It all happens in the mind, which is the first alchemy law. It's a mental universe, okay? So you need to access that world first, right? If she can't orgasm, it's in her mind, all right? Now, there are a lot of massage techniques. Maybe you could get the body to orgasm, but I just got a video. Malachi was there. One of the gurus in the world, right? I was like, I gotta buy this shit. Before I came here, I bought everyone's shit. If you're here, I bought your shit. And it was like an hour massage, you know? And they have this like girl and the camera's on her, they're massaging her pussy like for an hour. I'm like, dude.
Not stiff fingers.
No, I'm not giving names, but maybe not. But massaging for an hour. I was like, damn, if I spend an hour massaging a girl's pussy for her to come, I'm missing something in life. Unless you love that. You're like, I'm a pussy massager, right? Here's my card. What do you do? Massage pussies all day long, baby. I charge for it. That's cool, right? But that's not my business. I'm not massaging pussies at all. Let's get into the mind, okay? All right. I'll take some questions until we run out of time. If you have any questions, please ask. Yes?
So, with my current target, it's all up to day 7 that everything kind of was confusing. Until that, it was constantly moving on that upward angle.
Yes.
It's a little bit more keto, a little bit more... the compliance, everything.
Yes.
On day 7, she said, I have a gift for you. I have a surprise.
Mm-hmm.
And she...
whipped out her dick.
No.
Here's my surprise.
She basically got a personal trainer to train both of us.
Yeah.
Like, it's her trainer, but
yeah.
It's like both of us. And because she knows I like working out, and it was a great way for us to hang out. And
yeah.
That's one of the... And so, as far as value goes, I know that what she's looking for, what she wants to be, is some of the things that I could mentor her on.
Yes.
And so that's part of the conversation.
Yes.
And that came out in maybe like day 4. So that was, this has been going on for 2 months.
Okay.
The last time we hung out, I don't know what happened, but after the working out, she did do keto, and I mean, she ketoed me, she was...
What level of keto? There's touching your hand, there's kissing you.
There's not kissing.
Yeah.
The time before that, I kissed her on the cheek.
Yes.
And we still hung out. And
yes.
Last time, she initiated, you know, she was getting close to me while we were working out.
Yes.
And all that stuff. But then after the hangout, we were in her car, and she was asking me questions about web design stuff, and I was telling her. But because she had to move her car out of the way, and she was like, all right, I'll talk to you later. Like, everything was just so rushed.
Yes.
In that last 10 minutes or whatever.
Yes.
And then since then, our phone conversations are really... different. They're
yes.
not the same as her, like, she usually sends emotional texts.
Yes.
These were very, like, questions about web design.
Yes.
And it was,
so what's your question?
My question is, how do I know?
If I was a doctor and you gave me symptoms, I would guess, and I would say, go check that and come back in 3 days if that pill doesn't work, right? And I would say that based on what you said, somebody new entered her life that she has a romantic
She already has a boyfriend.
Okay.
Before I came in.
Okay. And?
Like 3 years.
Okay. So if nobody entered new, I would say based on what you said, I don't know, just because you gave me, you know, 2 minutes of telling me what your life was for 7 days with her. I would say that she now is moving. Here's what happens with women sometimes, just so you know, right? You're hanging out with them, they have a boyfriend, right? They're all into you and shit. They're like, oh, I'll fucking come to LA with you. I'll go to fucking Canada with you. I'll go to the fucking moon with you. Like, yeah, great. I'll buy you a fucking ticket because I'm such a fool. You're like, great, yeah, all right. A couple days earlier, I can't do this right now. Happens a lot. You caught her at a time where she was looking at her man going, ah, you piece of shit. My life is ruined because of you. 3-4 days passes, something happens in her life. She's like, oh, I kind of need him. Okay? They flip-flop like this all the time. You will experience this. Your girl that has a guy will go cold suddenly, and then we'll get, you see there's a lot of nods. That's happened to you guys, right? When that happens for me, I know that happened, and I'm like, all right, whatever. Big fucking deal, because they always come back, right? They're trying to fix a broken fucking plate.
I don't want her to leave him or anything.
Yeah, good.
Never like that.
Good. Yeah. So I think that's what's going on, and what you should, what is it that you should do? Keep doing what you've been doing, and talk to other women. That's it. That is the only solution. It's like saying, what if that person's not gonna buy the computer for me? You're a computer salesman, right? And you're like, if I told you, keep spending more effort on selling that computer to that person, I would be wasting your time at that moment. I would tell you, keep selling to everybody else, and know that they want the computer, they'll be back. They just went back to their old computer for a minute because they found pictures of some shit. It's, those relationships are done. If she's with you, it's done. You get it? She's not stupid. She's done with him. Do you get that? Women are, they know what the fuck they're doing. I don't know what I was thinking. Yeah, but you know exactly what you're thinking. Okay? So, it's already done. You never get panicked if she goes back to her man. Ever. Like, God, please go back 10 times. Okay? Go back 20 times. Because every time you're with me and you go back, you realize what a piece of shit he is. Okay? That's my job. Enter my world for 2 days, 3, 4, 5 days. Go back to your shitty world and see where you are. I just did this with some bitch not too long ago. Okay? Kind of hung out with me. At the end of the night, she was like, I swear to God, I feel like I'm living a dream. I said, yes, a dream to you, real to me. This is my life, is your dream. Okay. A couple days later, her communication was off. So I saw her somewhere. I said, come here, let's talk. Sit down, what's up? Oh, I feel kind of guilty. Oh, really? Didn't seem so guilty when you were sitting on my dick. Now you feel guilty. Sat on my dick twice. First time, my fault. Shame on me. Shame on you. You know that's it? You can't sit on my dick twice and say you didn't know what the fuck you're doing. So I was like, listen, with me, there's no halfway point. Right? You either are or you're not. And if I lose interest in you, it's over. And I'm right there. I don't threaten, I mean it. Hi. A couple days later, we were gonna hang out, she texts me something. Oh, you know, I was like, that's alright. That's alright. Since then, the only time I think about her is if she comes up as an example. Okay? I wish her nothing but the worst in her life. And she's getting it. She's absolutely getting it. Because when you align yourself with the universal way, if to go against you is to go against the universe. So good luck, bitch. You're not going against Arash. Who the fuck is Arash? I don't even know who I am. You get it? That's the problem. That's why I'm not seducing her. The universe, God, whatever the fuck you want to call it, is seducing through me. Resist me all day long, bitch. That's why I can get up there and give the speech I gave earlier. And it sounds challenging, it sounds whatever. Well, go ahead, do something about it. Because you're not going against me. You're gonna crash yourself like you've never crashed before. I haven't said one untruth. Not one untruth has come out of my mouth since I've been speaking. So if you wanna fucking go against the truth, then go for it. It ain't gonna be me. I've done that when I was a child. No more, I'm done. Okay? All right, that was like way too deep for that question. Any other question? Yes?
You said about what you should, how you should create your reality. How did you word it?
What I say becomes my reality, or as I, what I speak becomes reality. Is that what you're saying? Abracadabra? You could look it up. I mean, it's not exact translation.
Okay.
There's different ones, but basically what you say becomes real, or what you speak becomes reality.
Okay.
It's very simple. For example, if we start to talk about relaxation, comfort, massage, warm water, feeling good, sleeping, and I started to yawn as I was talking. I was like, I'm just having a step. At some point, you're like, well, I'm kind of tired. Right? Because we're speaking it into life. And if I start to talk to you about inspiration and power and God-like presence and being able to take God's hands and handcuff and put him down and take the devil handcuff and make those motherfuckers kiss each other for once, you'd be like, God, I feel powerful. Yeah, that's how I think. Don't fuck with me. You know what I mean? I don't care who you are. So, but see, it's, what I speak becomes real. Okay? Yes. Yes.
She did say one thing that said, we are not going to hook up in the conversation.
Recently?
Yeah.
Yeah, there you go.
And I said, I'm not that easy. I got that from a few.
Yeah,
so
right.
I'm not that easy. Like, I just, you know, I calibrated the whole thing.
Yeah.
That was, like, in my cute way.
Yeah.
And then she repeated after me.
Yeah.
Like, that was one of the pieces I remember.
Yeah.
Does that mean she was thinking about hooking up?
If she says it. Or she thinks you were thinking about it, but it doesn't matter what she says. She goes, just so you know, we're not gonna hook up.
Yeah, she said that.
Say, why the fuck am I wasting my time with you then? No, I'm just kidding. I mean, me could say that. I've said that before. But see, I go out of my way. Listen, let me explain this to the world on camera. I don't have friends that are girls. Everybody get that? I don't have the concept of a girl being my friend only. Meaning what? That I don't have access to her sexuality. Like, why in the fucking world would I want that? To tease myself? Huh? To be disgenuine around her? To pretend some shit? All women around me need to know that. Every one of them. Don't come around, don't spend an hour, don't spend a fucking minute with me. Okay? If you're gonna keep your fucking sexuality to you, then I keep my mind and my communication to me. Because that's my value. Got it? Go watch my fucking videos, bitch, but don't talk to me. I'll give that to somebody who knows how to exchange with me. So if she thinks you have friends that are... No, I hook up with girls, okay? I hook up with girls. I don't want to hook up with you. That's fine. Then don't answer calls anymore. Don't text me. How's that? Okay? Or laugh it off and keep hanging out. Keep Kino here. Keep trying to make out with her. Until she's like, stop. I don't want to hang out. Say, good. Now I know. Then never, ever, ever talk to her again. That's it. She's done. In your mind, finish her. She's finished. Fatality. It's over. Boom. It's over. Move on. Don't waste your time. Okay, anything else? I'm just kind of waiting for Vince. Yes.
You made a statement about when you're meeting a girl or something like that, you say something like, you know, you've had good relationships, bad relationships, I've had good ones, you've had bad
yes,
ones.
Yes, yes.
Okay, it seems like something, even though we're not robots, it seems like something that could apply to every girl you meet.
Yes.
Would you say that to, have you, or would you say it to most girls you meet? Or
I don't really use that statement, but I would if I had to. I'm just teaching you the polarity. How do I use it? I use it like this. I use it like this. We may have sex, we may not have sex. See this? If we have sex, I'm okay with it, it's gonna be great. If we don't have sex, I'm okay with it, it's gonna be great. Here's what we're all gonna do. We're gonna be comfortable, we're gonna have a good time. Any point I don't have a good time, I don't wanna hang out anymore. Say what's for you, understood? We're good. All right, now, yeah, oh yeah, absolutely I'll say that. If I feel it in the room, I feel she's thinking he wants to fuck me, so I bring it up right away. Yeah. We could have sex, but not have sex, just so you know, right? You're not my only access to pussy. Oh my God, were you in the strip club with me? I said that last night a bunch of times. Right? I said that a bunch of times. I said, I'm fucking somebody tonight. It may not be you. It'll be somebody. Right? Of course. Like duh. Right? That obviously, that's what I'm going to do. So if it's not you, that's fine. If it's you, that's great. You'll have a great time. Okay, so I just call it in the room. I'm not so vulgar. I'm very smooth when I talk, so I'm not like a dick. But I bring it out. If it's in the air, I'll bring it out. No problem.
It seems like it's in the air a lot. Like,
it is.
Yeah, I mean,
it is. It's in the air. You're a guy, so the girl, sex in the air. Sex is in the air. Question?
No.
Okay. Yes.
In that type of situation, do you shoot the game or do you go dance with the girl?
I dance if dancing is the best thing to do. It depends on what it offers. Last night we went to, I think it was Avalon. I was like, this place is shit, right? But you know what I did? Who's here? You? Yes, well, you saw that. There you are. That's what I'm talking about, okay? So I took him and I said, look, here is what I would do, because I've done what I showed him, a process. You go into the middle of that drugged out crowd, right? It's like the fucking DJs out there. What the fuck do DJs do these days? Come on, bro. So you go into the middle of the crowd. No one's seeing you, no one's judging you, they're all drugged out anyways, right? And you work on loosening yourself up, and just... And then you look to your left and you see a move you like, oh. And you get to the point where you're just like, what's up, right? And you just move. I've done this many times, right? I can dance because of that. So I told him, I said, this is the opportunity. I wouldn't pick up on girls here because where the fuck are they? And the ones that are there, they're going, hey, good question. You know? But you loosen up. Because you have to be loose to pick up. Right? He's very buff. Sometimes I'm like, if I look like these buff guys, dude, I'd be like, God, come here, baby. Look at this shit. I don't have that. I don't have that physique, right? But if I was very buff, I'd make sure I'm not stiff. Hey, good question. So I was getting to loosen up. Because if he was loose and he's sick as fuck, for example, Hananger, he's buff, but he's not tight. But he's not as tight as most buff guys, right? So that's when I used that. Then he brought a girl over, and I was talking to her. It was more, you could hear each other on this part. And she was a tough, tough girl, man. But exchanged numbers at the end, no problem. So it just depends what the environment calls for at that time. Whoever asked that question, right there. Yeah, you get it? That's it. But my game, we say in Seduction and say, life is game, game is life. Because wherever you go, is where you're gonna be gaming, right? Wherever you go. Felicia, I met at the mall. Hannah, I met at the tanning salon. Electra, I met at a gym. Serena, I met at Hooters. And Raquel, I met through her friend. I was fucking around with her friend. And she brought her in. I was like, switch. Way better. Okay, any other questions? So it just depends what life offers you. Take it. Here's an exercise. I should have a nickel in here somewhere. That this nickel is significant because I make good money. It's not that one. It's one of these is a nickel. I was walking in the hotel and I saw a nickel on the ground. And I was like, oh, a nickel. And then I was like, oh, turn around, pick it up. By myself, nobody's around. And I put it in. And I was like, you know, I've decided to be a multi-fucking millionaire very soon. And so if I'm walking and the universe gives me a nickel, I'll take it. I'll say thank you. Because before that nickel, I did that with pennies recently. Newton's like, penny? Fuck penny. No, I'll take it. Thank you. Okay? Then it was a nickel. I'm like, yeah, that's five times what I was making before. So you can't ask for shit and then complain. Right? So sometimes, this is why recently I hooked up a bunch of not too attractive women. It's like, I'm going to be the greatest seduction master anywhere ever. Like, I'm just going to go down history as nothing's ever been able to do what I did. And then suddenly, there's all these bitches who want to fuck me and then hang out with me. I'm like, no. I'm like, whoa, that's like a penny. Take it. Come here, baby. Bring your large ass right here. Let's go through the rules. God damn, this is different. You know what I mean? It's different. It's different until their mouth hits your dick. Then it's not that different. And then you close your eyes, and it's not different at all. But when you come and you open your mouth, your eyes, it's very different. It's 10 times worse than it was prior. She goes from 200 pounds to 600 pounds. But when you're feeling it, and she, you know, you're like, oh, it's gonna blow me. She goes from 200 pounds to like 160, 120. Hair grows longer, lips get fuller. Suddenly, you know what you see? I swear to God, this happened to me. All you see is her lips. She becomes a floating lip in the universe, right? It just goes on your dick. Then you come and then you see the whole figure. Oh, Shamu, you know what I got here. But whatever, you know what? I'm thankful. I'm thankful. Every fucking woman that came around and pleasured me any way they did. And I'll accept more, keep going, keep doing shit. Okay? Arash, you don't have any standards. Your mom doesn't have any standards. Yeah.
Where can we learn more about alchemy?
Alchemy, you can try to find it and see what you come up with. Or you could convince me to teach it. I'm on that path now, right? Or you can find it. Google, bookstore, get ready to be fully confused. Anybody ever tried studying that shit? Yeah, I'm fucked up, right? You're like, oh, that's kind of cool, makes sense. How do I apply that shit? Exactly, okay? But I'm teaching it, and I will more and more. Any other questions? Vince, are you here?
Okay. There.
Let me just say how much
walk that way.
Okay, any other questions? I offended you already, great. Any other questions? Okay, no, yes.
So your reality is a little different from everyone else's. Mm-hmm. I recently stopped traditional dating. Mm-hmm. I just do hangout dating. Because mm-hmm. Why am I going to drop money on them?
Yeah.
So do you want to, like, can you...
Talk about that?
How you do it, maybe, or... How you
I don't date. Vince has said you date people you're fucking, or is that him today?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
100% agree with that, right? I spend a lot of money on my women. If you follow me on Facebook and Instagram, man, I will fucking take the money and I will spend it on them. They're my woman. And if she's new, I won't. Unless I'm spending it on an experience. Let me tell you what I mean by that. Let's say I get a limo and she happens to be hanging out with me. Remember, I'm riding the limo with a hot girl too. Okay? She gets the benefit from that. I'm not spending it on her. She's hanging out with me being in the fucking limo. Get a difference? One of my friends the other day, one time, I was like, you know, what's this wine tasting shit all about? I've been broke for so fucking long. Let me go wine taste this damn thing. But it was like I was at a restaurant and I was like, you guys, the wine is a whole, you know, oh my God, there's a whole thing to that thing, right? So I was like, that wine. I was like, damn, money's just going. Pa, 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 pa. And I'm looking at her, I'm going, you know what? I don't think her exchange is fully in to be experiencing this shit with me right now, right? I was like, but you know what? It ain't about her. I'm tasting this wine, she happens to be here, and that's okay. So that's how I spend money. Otherwise, hang out, it's the way to do it, man. Hang out with girls. Hang out. Listen, man, let me make your mind easy. Do whatever the fuck you need to do. Make all the goddamn mistakes you need to make. No one's got it. I don't got it. Straight up. I don't have it. I thought I had it 2 years ago. Two years ago, Arash would not be able to hang with this Arash, not even close. I mean, not even, just what the fuck was that guy? Hopefully I can look back and say the same shit about today, and I will. I keep going, right? So I don't know it, man. I know what I know right now. It's like a weather, it changes, right? So wherever you are is where you need to be. Just, you get inspired, you pick up ideas, maybe something I said really works, something, so, you know, I've been watching all the speakers and I picked up something from all of them. Oh, even if it was, I would never do that shit. Good to know. Right? No, that happened twice. Well, I was like, oh, well, that was the worst shit I ever heard. And I was like, good, because I hadn't put the words on it. Now I know the words that describe that shitty condition that person just talked, okay? So, but I went in there with the state of mind of I'm gonna learn some shit and you'll get what you're going to. Is that me?
Let's see.
Hello?
I have time, sure.
Grandma's house.
My girlfriend.
In the middle of a lecture, everyone's listening to you. Hi. I did. I wanted to see if you were there. Okay. I'm gonna go. This is the lecture. Okay, can you say hi, lecture, on the count of three? One, two, three.
Hi, lecture.
That's because they're all half asleep. I've been talking too long. Okay, bye. Okay. You want to talk to that? Is she what? Is she here? No. Is this you again? Okay, Sarah's here. She's always thought you were so beautiful. She'll stop you. This is Sarah. Okay. Anything else? Now, look, let me explain something to you. Because I've always told you, game is life, life is game. You're observing it right now. Mm-hmm. Let's go ahead and just did. It's happening right now is a moment of my life. A slice of my life. Akita's saying beyond the game, slice of life. You're seeing it right now. It's the girl I'm with my number one girl. It's been with me the longest. Talk out. Figure it out, girls. Okay? I'm not gonna lose anything in this process. Nothing. Because they're both beautiful, they're both gorgeous, they know what each other looks like, and they will respect each other. Okay? Done. What else? Okay, yes, over there, and then we're coming.
You're hanging out, like, let's say you just met the girl.
Yes.
Alright. What is your idea of hanging out? Where are you taking her? Obviously, you're not taking her on a date. Is it back to your place?
They all come to my office. The Seductive Instinct headquarters. If you walk in, you would know. You would just know. Just walk into the place. What the fuck is here? Okay, thank you.
As a teacher, how do I isolate students? Like, I don't have an office like that.
Yeah, you need to have a seduction location. I really recommend that, you know? You just gotta figure it out. Even if you get a small office of 400 square feet and you pay $500 a month, right? Set it up nicely and make it your meditation space. See that? So they meet you in your meditation. You know one of the coolest things I fucking did? Because I actually, like, that's how it was, I meant it. Is the woman came from out of town, high profile woman. And we're hanging out, went to the hotel room that I got her. And I said, I need to get my meditation in. So I'm gonna put my clock for 20 minutes, if you don't mind. Just give me 20 minutes. She's like, okay. Sat on the couch, 20 minutes. And then before I start, she goes, do you mind if I meditate with you? I said, no. She goes, well, what meditation technique are you doing? I said, I can't share that. But you could try this, this, and that. I'd give her three things that she can do, but it wouldn't be mine. Put the fucking clock, 20 minutes later. Bing, 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 bing. Hung out. She still texts me and says, thank you for that meditation. That was one of the coolest things I ever did. Fuck yeah. Right? So you just get a space that has to be, I really recommend a seduction location. It changes things. But it's not a seduction location, it's a meditation place. It's a place where you do your headquarters, office, or whatever the fuck you do. Do what you want to do. But somewhere private where you can control the locks and the music and the colors and the smells. Okay? Where you're not going to get barged in on. All right? Seduction headquarters, no woman has a key to it. I don't care who they are. Yes?
You're out of town?
Out of town, motel. Wherever. It's easier out of town. Yes?
How many in-game shifts did you have before you could, like, get girls to talk to other girls? Or, like, you could tell your girlfriend you were going to have...
You know, it's a constant, spontaneous thing that happens.
Okay.
I observe life. Remember we talked about, I listen to it. I pay attention to what the fuck's happening. And then I guide her.
Okay.
Right? She talked to Lecha. First time I talked to you, Lecha, right? Was it okay? Did you guys get in a fight? Okay? That's the first time where I'm like, hey, let's call back and go talk. Why? Because it was available right now. Right? As I was getting off the phone, I was up there and said, oh, fuck, these two should talk. You know? There you go. I'm glad that they didn't get in a fight. That's a good sign. Okay? Yes?
So one of the things you teach is having value and exchanging value, right? You said that yours is like the communication and the mind and stuff, right?
That's what I know it is. They think maybe other shit. I don't know what they think.
So, say you're hanging out with a girl, and it's like, how much you give up the value? And how, like, so for example, I was going to put it in terms of me.
Yes.
So if I'm going to teach her something, when do I do that? As in, like, how much do you give away without feeling you're giving away too much?
Thank you. Okay, no, let me tell you why that's important. If anybody sees Vince, just let him know I'm done and I'm just talking. Okay, here's what's important about that, okay? Because we have a live demonstration here. At some point when we were hanging out, here's what I said to her. I said, tonight I'm going to be in a certain state of mind. And from last night to tonight, I'm in a different state of mind. I'm going to keep increasing it. I know my levels. And I said, I need to know where you are mentally and where I'm at mentally so that I don't feel like you're using me. And she's like, she's not using me. And then I said, listen, I'm not saying using like the way people use using. I'm saying it like this. What I'm putting in and what you're putting in has to match in my mind. And right now it's not. And I just need to know where you are so I can calibrate myself there so that I feel good about us. Is this a fact or not?
It's a fact.
Then we worked it out to where we are now, which is I feel great about her being here. She feels great about being here. You see that? But that's why, because I started to feel now this could be my delusion, and it probably is, but it's I have to clear myself up so I'm not hanging out being weird. So after the conversation, we calibrated correctly, boom, now we've just had the greatest time since. So I go until it feels off. Okay? I start to feel I'm giving too much. It depends how much I care. Normally I wouldn't have that conversation. I like her a lot.
She feels that she's not giving me enough. A lot of the times,
yeah.
Like she actually paid for our dinner once with her boyfriend's credit card, and I was like, "Is that like
fucking
okay?" And I was like, "I just went with it because she was investing."
Yeah,
like,
tell her to buy you some shoes next time with it too. Jesus Christ!
Yeah. I like giving. So
yes,
it's like
good.
For me, when I get that, it's
yes.
like I really appreciate that.
Yes.
And at the same time, it's like, you know, she keeps feeling like she wants to do more, but then I'm like,
say, spread your legs then.
The last time she got the trainer, I think, so...
She keeps giving you what you don't want.
Yeah!
That's why, that's the problem. You know? It's like, why are you giving me something I don't want? It's like going to Africa and the kid's starving for food, and you get him a Nike hat. And he's like...
She said she doesn't want to fall into the same trap that I have with other women that I'm fucking.
Tell her to shut up. Jesus. You're listening to her, that's your problem. I went over it earlier. She doesn't know shit! You're letting her dictate. I just want to make sure I don't fall. Shut the fuck up. Do you talk to yourself that much, you crazy bitch? You know? Don't tell me. Look, let me read you a text so you understand. Okay? A new woman. New woman as of what? Before I drove here, Friday. From Facebook to text. And the text. goes to here. At some point it says, I don't want to make anyone upset by me talking to you. That's her, right? Similar vibe. She says, drive safe and have fun. Watch how I said, I said, haha, that's cute. I have 5 girlfriends, love. And I am with any woman that I desire. And no one has anything to say about it, and never will. You and I will be good friends, and what we decide to do between us as adults is no one's business, not even God. She says, I like that. You are definitely someone I want in my life, the kiss face. Handled. They didn't argue. I just told her how things are. You get it? Don't accept the world that the woman gives you. It's a shitty world. You don't want to live in that shit. It's fucked up, man. It's not like rainbows and Mother Nature and, oh, I'm breathing and I'm so free as a woman. It's more like, oh, what do I fucking do? How come he hasn't called me? Am I fat? Am I ugly? My hair's fucked up. What am I gonna do with my life? I'm getting older and uglier. Without makeup, I'm nothing. You know what I mean? That's fucked up. I don't wanna live in that shit. It's fucked up. Don't let her tell you anything, man. Be quiet. Okay, yes, question here? No? Okay, yes. I don't allow them to stick with me, bro. They just fucking are. I haven't had a script today. I haven't had a script yesterday. I never have had a script. I've never had a fucking mic.
For us, like, side practice.
How do you guys do it?
Yeah, like, how do you keep it to stick?
It's real simple. I don't think about anything else. That's why. Right? I don't have my brain sectioned off, my mind into many things. This is what I do all the time. I think about, like, who else said that? Somebody said they do 24 hours a day. Some speaker said that, right? I get that. This is all I do. Right? So I don't know how you're going to do it, but I don't do anything else. So for me, it doesn't make sense to do anything else, right? I mean, you could put me in front of the president right now. I could have a great conversation. Right? And he'd be like, bring him here, or whatever the fuck his accent is, right? So that's worth something to me. I don't want to do anything else. Okay? No one can find Vince? Let me call Vince.
No, I texted him.
And?
I haven't heard from him.
He's out here.
Can you get him?
He's like doing a film in the elevator.
Oh.
Okay. Let me call him, maybe he'll know that it's a little more serious.
Awesome, thanks Arash.
You're welcome, I've been losing weight, sweating here. Mm-hmm. I lost a couple pounds already.
Arash, I have a question.
Yeah.
After you're done calling.
Yeah, please.
Okay, this is a question about social circle, okay?
Yeah.
So obviously when it's social circle, the girls, you're surrounded by girls, guys, whether it's work, college, whatever. So I guess the approach and the comfort doesn't really matter because you see these people every day, you interact, whatever you do, right? So, when it comes to the point of, let's say, you're pursuing one of the girls, and this goes back to, like, the old mystery method when it's like, oh, when the village hears that this guy was rejected and then now all the women don't want him.
Yeah.
So, with that theory, let's say in that case, or if, you know, you're pursuing one of the girls and then it doesn't work out and then you go for another one, now they all know, like, oh, he tried to go with
yeah.
this one and
yeah.
now he's trying to get at us.
Yeah.
So, what are some of your, like, tips and, like, do's and don'ts for social circle game?
This is why we talk about the seductive instinct method, if you heard Akito's talk. See, I never pursue the girl.
Okay.
So I don't have that problem. I'm done. You get that? So I'm not hitting on her. I'm not pursuing her. I'm not doing anything like that. So there's no rejection.
So how do you eventually get her then?
I get every woman. She starts to become comfortable, relaxed, intrigued, sexual. She sees my power. She wants me. What is this? Let's take a moment and admire this. This is my admiration posture.
Included the men, notice that.
No, I missed it. I just saw Vince. I was like, Vince too. Okay, hold on. Let me see. There you go. I appreciate beauty. There we go. Okay, good. That's
Arash,
it. Yes.
Everybody that is press or cameras and so on, if you want to start to head towards the Avalon, okay? Be outside by the pink carpet. Anybody else that's VIP general admission, you head over there as well. Wait outside, the party will begin in a moment. Okay. You gotta go get the awards real quick. And then Arash, we tag along with Nick and we'll go in the Hummer. So you guys, we'll meet you over there, okay? Photographers, if you can all be ready on the carpet, we appreciate that.
Aye.
Okay. And then, last quick thing, what was it? Something comes to mind, I forgot.
Be the best, fuck the rest.
Yes, everybody! Be the best, fuck the rest! Be the best! Right. 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 Right.